First tonight at 7, these 16 men are behind bars accused of seeking sex from children.
Yeah, and they were caught after an undercover law enforcement operation. And every time police do one of these, they seem to catch a significant number. Fox 10's Marissa Sarback has more.
They've caught 16 in this sting, but law enforcement says they can't possibly catch them all. We see operations like this all of the time, and the frequency seems to be increasing. And that's because there was always a demand for illegal sex acts from minors.
Our undercover detectives put out ads on these websites that are highly sought out by these suspects that seek out these sex acts.
Phoenix Police Department detectives have spent weeks pretending to be minors online, conversing with these 16 men who they say were seeking illegal sex acts from minors. Phoenix PD, Tempe PD, and Mesa PD were involved, as well as the FBI, Maricopa County Attorney's Office, and Homeland Security. Police say the men were trying to meet children.
Typically, during the end of the conversation, they might want to meet up somewhere and go through with what was already suggested or solicited.
These departments conduct child sex crime stings so frequently, proving the demand for sex from minors is always there.
There's never enough times to do this. These people need to be taken off the streets, and unfortunately, it's incidents like this or operations like this that help us catch them before they're able to victimize a child.
Sergeant Melissa Solis with Phoenix PD says these are regular people who walk among us, oftentimes unsuspected by anyone in their lives.
We don't know who these people are because they have regular working jobs, white-collared, blue-collared jobs, and in order to catch them, we need them to commit the act.
Phoenix PD says the individual charges will depend on how those conversations go and how conversations continue to go with people accused of this. They also said the charges will depend on the Maricopa County Attorney's Office. Reporting outside police headquarters, Marissa Sarback, Fox 10 News.
The Maricopa County Sheriff's Office arrests two people they believe were stealing power from APS.
Yeah, the utility company is claiming that those suspects were supplying their business with stolen power from an APS box. But the story only gets more wild from there. 61-year-old Laura Swink and her 35-year-old son Steven were taken into custody for the theft. But while police were serving the warrant, they found a large underground bunker on the property. That bunker was made from several semi-truck boxes that were stacked together to make a three-level building. And inside was that ladder, as you saw, a ladder system and tunnels, several chemical containers, bags of some kind of powder, and glass cylinders. Police also found several guns, a pound of meth, cocaine, cash, other drugs. Again, it was about thousands of dollars in currency they found, more than $500,000 in gold and silver. So far, the mother and son are only facing charges for the power theft, but this case obviously has a lot more to it.
In other news, a drug bust as two men are accused of selling fentanyl out of a smoke shop in Mesa. Casey Thornton and Devontae Williams were arrested this week. Thornton on the left owns the Green Trail Smoke Shop near University Drive and Alma School Road. Detectives say the men were selling counterfeit oxidone pills known as M30 fentanyl. That can be deadly. Police say Williams worked at the shop and admitted he may have sold fentanyl twice. Thornton told police he got the pills from a Mexican cartel and has been selling them for about 7 months. We talked with a former customer who works at a rehab center and sees people suffering from fentanyl use all the time.
Fentanyl pills are everywhere, and it's really scary because these kids nowadays, they're not going to smoking weed off the bat, they're going straight to these pills and it's killing them. I mean, I've known lots of friends that have died from them.
The Attorney General's office is reviewing this case.
A woman accused of driving the wrong way on the Loop 202 Red Mountain Highway has been arrested. This is 22-year-old Julie Balcom, who was booked into jail on aggravated DUI charges. The DPS says multiple 911 calls started coming in just before midnight of someone driving east in those westbound lanes near Alma School Road. Troopers caught up with her eventually near Wrecker Road and used a pit maneuver to stop her car. They say her blood alcohol level was 0.186.
An arrest is made in a break-in at the campaign office for Democratic candidate for governor Katie Hobbs.
Yeah, Fox 10's Irene Snyder joining us live now with the latest on these new developments. Irene.
Well, hey, Renee and Troy, police announced this morning they arrested the suspect who they believe broke into Katie Hobbs' campaign office on Tuesday. Now, Hobbs' campaign manager says there were several items taken from the Democratic nominee for governor's office during that burglary. They will not tell us exactly what's missing. Police have not released the name of the suspect and have not speculated if the crime was politically motivated. We did get, though, these photos from Hobbs' campaign manager of an individual on what appears to be the surveillance video in her office. We're blurring them at this point since police have not confirmed that this person is the suspect. We spoke with Katie Hobbs during a meeting about abortion this morning. She refused to answer any questions about the break-in. Again, police at this point have not identified who that suspect is, but an arrest was made. We spoke with police earlier today. They say they will be releasing more information and speaking with us later on this afternoon. Stay with Fox 10 for the latest on air and online. For now, reporting live at Phoenix PD, I'm Irene Snyder for Fox 10 News.